everyone. My name's Julia, and I'm an educator at the Columbia River Maritime Museum. The Columbia River Bar, where the Columbia River meets with the Pacific Ocean, is considered one of the most dangerous waterways in the world. And since 1800, the graveyard of the Pacific has claimed over 2,000 ships. Each month, leading up to the opening of the museum's Shipwrecks exhibit, the Education Department will feature one famous shipwreck that fell victim to the graveyard of the Pacific. This month, we're talking about the USS Peacock. The original Peacock was built in the middle of the War of 1812. The building contract was given to Adam and Noah Brown, shipbuilders from New York who were known for building speedy ships. The Peacock's name was in commemoration of an American victory over an enemy ship, the HMS Peacock, which was sunk by the USS Hornet in 1813. The Peacock accidentally fired some of the last shots of the War of 1812, almost 6 months after the war had already been over, since the skipper was apparently unaware that the war had ended. After the war, the Peacock was repurposed on missions to confront pirate and slave ships traveling through the Atlantic. It sailed around the globe for 14 years before being decommissioned at Brooklyn Naval Yard in 1827. The original Peacock was built in 1813, but that technically isn't the same ship that wrecked in 1841. During the 1820s and 30s, the U.S. Navy began shifting its focus to unexplored, remote areas that could be important for the world's trade routes. In order to explore some of that uncharted territory, the U.S. Navy founded a new squadron known as the United States Exploring Expedition. The Exploring Expedition, nicknamed the XX, was the first U.S. Navy scientific investigation of the Pacific Ocean, and the USS Peacock was the first vessel chosen for the job. But first, it had to be completely rebuilt for the task. At the time, Congress was agreeing to pay for the repair of older ships, but not for building brand new ships. For the expedition to get around this loophole, the Peacock was rebuilt from 1828 to 1829, ignoring the fact that it was basically being replaced by a new vessel with the old frame. 9 scientists and artists were on board the crew of the Peacock and the rest of the squadron, which consisted of the ships USS Vincennes, Relief, Porpoise, Seagull, and Flying Fish, and was led by Lieutenant Charles Wilkes. The second in command of the squadron, Lieutenant William L. Hudson, commanded the Peacock. The remade Peacock sailed from Virginia in 1838 and traveled around Cape Horn to get to the Pacific Ocean. For 2 years, the squadron explored the South Pacific Islands and the Antarctic coastline. Some ships split off from the original group to explore the Puget Sound in Washington, and they agreed they would meet back at the Columbia River in the summer of 1841. While stopping with his crew for supplies in Hawaii, Lieutenant Hudson actually spoke with another captain who gave him instructions on how to cross the Columbia River Bar safely. But it wasn't enough. The Peacock arrived at the southern entrance of the river, with Point Adams in sight, on July 17, 1841. The Columbia River was an important landmark to the squadron, which viewed it as the grand finale to their work. But they also dreaded crossing the river, fearing that it would mean disaster for one of their ships. On July 18, the Peacock attempted to cross the bar. When Hudson originally sailed to the mouth of the river from the south, he saw breaker waves that convinced him he was in the wrong spot from the instructions that the captain in Hawaii had given him. He sailed north to where the ocean wasn't breaking, but at that point he was too far away from where he should have been. Instead, he was dangerously close to a place that would soon be known as Peacock Spit. Peacock Spit isn't technically a fully fledged spit. Instead, it's more like a spit-shaped sandbar that runs about 6 miles out from the north entrance to the Columbia River. The sandbar is almost invisible at first glance. The ocean waves cover it up to make that area seem much deeper than it really is. When the exploring expedition reached the Columbia, the spit wasn't known to most sailors as a threat, mostly because not a lot was known about navigating the bar in general. This incident put the spit on the map. Around 11:30 in the morning on July 18, Hudson and his crew fought against strong winds and swirling currents to get the Peacock across the bar, but it was no use. The Peacock ran aground early in the afternoon and quickly became stuck on the spit. Hudson and his crew tried to lighten the ship by throwing cannonballs over the side, and they lowered anchors to try to stabilize her where she was. But as the Peacock became more and more entrenched in the spit, the crew's main mission was to make sure she stayed pointed towards the waves instead of going broadside to them. Hudson and his crew began to realize that the Peacock could not be saved, and Hudson ordered an evacuation of the ship. The other ships from the squadron helped get the crew, their scientific instruments, and other supplies off the Peacock before heading to Baker's Bay near the foot of Cape Disappointment. missionaries from Point Adams came to the crew with tents and food after witnessing the accident. Eventually, an official from the Hudson's Bay Company near Fort George, or present-day Astoria, came to help too. Amazingly, only one crew member suffered significant injuries from the incident, and there were no other major casualties. On July 21, Hudson and his crew migrated to Fort George and set up a camp there that they called Peacockville, where they flew the Peacock's American flag. When Lieutenant Wilkes arrived at the Columbia River, he replaced the Peacock with the Thomas Perkins, which he purchased from the Hudson's Bay Company. Wilkes renamed the Thomas Perkins the Oregon, and the Oregon and the Porpoise from the original squadron continued upriver to explore as far as the Cascades. The ocean tore the Peacock apart, and only the bowsprit was left to mark what had happened there. The expedition named the spit after the ship it had destroyed to truly memorialize the incident. But Peacock Spit isn't the ship's only namesake. The Columbia River Bar Pilot's boat, Peacock, was built in 1964 and put into service on the Columbia River in 1967. She was specially designed to help pilots navigate all the extreme weather conditions that they face on the Columbia River Bar. The boat is 90 feet long, 33 feet tall, and was the first self-riding pilot boat to be used on the river. The stern of the Peacock was also rigged up with a 23-foot-long daughter boat that could be used in heavy weather. Over the course of her 33-year career, the Peacock helped the bar pilots shepherd over 120,000 commercial vessels across the bar. She was decommissioned in 1999. In 2010, the Columbia River bar pilots donated the Peacock to the Columbia River Maritime Museum to be preserved and displayed on our campus. Few ships have the same level of historical significance to the Columbia River as this pilot boat. The USS Peacock's infamous shipwreck became the namesake for Peacock Spit and the beloved pilot boat Peacock. Next month, the Columbia River Maritime Museum Shipwreck Series will feature the SS Laurel. Thanks for watching!